Notion is an amazing tool, but it can get overwhelming with increasing number of pages and templates. In today's video, I'll share 3 simple tips to keep your Notion workspace organized and efficient so you can make the most of this productivity app. Tip number 1 is to create a brain dump page. Notion's real usefulness lies in its databases, but more databases can sometimes lead to more confusion. It's easy to blur the lines between projects and tasks or to lose sight of what's truly essential. Here's where a brain dump page comes in. It's essentially a blank slate where you can jot down anything. Create a new Notion page, name it Brain Dump, give it an appealing icon, and add it to your favorites. This way, you can quickly access your Brain Dump page from the sidebar. Throughout the day, I can easily pull out my phone and note down thoughts, ideas, or errands on the same page. In the evening, I will review this page on my desktop, categorizing everything appropriately or deciding on the next steps. I find it beneficial to let an idea marinate before acting on it, as sometimes what seems crucial might just be a distraction or not as important as we thought. Tip number 2 is to add Notion widgets. For those with numerous Notion pages, this tip is a game changer. Navigating to the correct page in Notion can be tedious, especially considering the initial load time of the Notion app. The solution? Home screen widgets. I'll guide you through the setup on my iPad, but this trick is equally effective on phones and with the latest macOS update, even on your Mac desktop. Press and hold on your iPad screen and then tap the plus icon in the top left corner. Search for Notion and add a small widget by dragging it to your home screen and then position it wherever you want it. I will add a few more widgets for quick access to different pages. Edit the widget to select your workspace and choose the desired page. If you have trouble choosing the right page, just open the page in Notion and then when you search for it in the widget, it should appear at the top. A bonus tip, stack related pages like my finance pages, budget and investments. After stacking, you can easily scroll to view each item in the stack. Notion widgets are also great on your phone, acting as a launchpad for your favorite Notion pages. With the latest macOS update, you can even add Notion widgets to your Mac desktop. The process is similar. Find the Notion widget, add it to your home screen, and then right-click to edit and select the desired page. This action opens the Notion page in your browser. If you prefer the desktop app, adjust the Notion browser settings to always open in the app. Now you're just a click away from your frequently used Notion pages. Tip number 3 is having a consistent system. Overwhelm often stems from a lack of structure. Crafting an organization system takes time, so why not start with a proven one and tailor it as needed? I recommend starting with the PERA method by Thiago Forte. It's a strategy for organizing digital information, standing for projects, areas, resources, and archive. Despite my proficiency with Notion, I too struggled with organizing my information in Notion as they grew. The PERA method clarified how to categorize different pieces of information, providing a clear structure for easy capture and retrieval. For a detailed guide on implementing PERA in Notion, check out the video in the description below. And yes, there's a free Notion template waiting for you. So when you feel overwhelmed in Notion, remember these 3 simple tips: brain dump for clarity, add widgets for accessibility, and have a structured system for consistency. Stay productive, and I'll see you in the next video.